Hi everyone, today I'm here with my video and it is about toys because this is the most requested video. It's quite confusing because the market is full of toys and each brand is promoting their own toys and it becomes really confusing for mothers to when and at which age we have to start what kind of toy and even if it is providing any value or not. So we are going to discuss all the issues. Before proceeding further, let me tell you what is a toy. When you see a toy, what all comes to your mind? So is it just a playful activity or it is much more than that? Actually, it delivers values which are beyond our imagination. Toys are your baby's little helpers and they help them grow all kind of skills, develop various kinds of skills with time, be it cognitive, social, gross, fine, motor, any kind of skills. So we have to be very selective while buying toys. At the same time, we should make it clear that we don't, overbuy toys because they are plastic and we don't want to burden this nature as well. So we have to be precise. One toy which can do many functions, I would suggest toys like that. So let's start. So I'll be making the video in four parts. I'll divide it like 0 to 6 months, then 6 to 12 months, 12 to 18, and then 18 to 24, and then from there so on. Coming to the first part, 0 to 6 months. So when a baby is born, his senses are not fully developed, be it eyes or ears or touch or hold. It's not fully developed. Even their eyes, they can't see, completely, or they can't see a distant object very clearly. So from 0 to 6 months, we have to be careful about choosing colors and what kind of sound it is producing, because those are called sensory toys. The toys which you buy should be appealing to their eyes and ears from a distance, as they can't actually figure out what exactly the toy is about. So you have to choose very bright colored toys, block colors like yellow, red, blue, so that they can see a bit, whatever they can, and it should be appealing to their eyes. Then you have toys like rattles, which make cute sounds and which they can hear and just use their hands to wave in the air. So you have to buy toys which have little motion effect. It should walk, it should crawl on its own, the baby can see and enjoy. Then you have toys like drum, anything which they thump with their hands or legs and it will make some sound or some attractive lighting effect. So babies, they enjoy these kind of toys. These are called mostly sensory toys. And I'll show you what all I gave Agu when he was between 0 to 6 months. See, most of the toys I'll be showing you, they will be half broken or you won't find the other parts. So really sorry for that, but you can get an idea, okay? So my first favorite is this hanging toy. I used to hang this over his cot and these used to move and the baby could see and feel calm and composed, and it also helps to make them sleep better. So this is a must for your child's cot if they are between 0 to 6 months. Next is really important and my favorite, and it was a savior when Agu was not able to sit and he used to lie down mostly. So this is a must for every parent. So this is called a play gym mat. And you can spread it on the bed and it has some, hanging. This is a cute mirror where babies can see their face. And these are some hanging nice toys. So this is from Fisher Price. I'll put the link below and you can directly buy them from there. So these are really nice, portable, and you can carry it anywhere. Just spread it and lay down your baby over this and your baby is happy and sorted. So this is my favorite. Okay, after that, which I like the most, this is this bouncer. This is again by Fisher Price, and bouncer or rocker you can say. I used to lay a goo there and put the belt and it used to just, he used to sleep on this only and I used to do my work in the room. So this is actually helpful, and you don't have to rock the baby on your lap all the time because that can give you a backache as well. So this is a very nice substitute for your lap. Next is rattle. They make cute sounds. Make sure baby is able to hold it and just play with it. I'll share the link down. And babies are mostly, you know, they have the tendency to take things in mouth. So you need to give them nice teethers and soothers of different shapes and sizes. So this is this octopus soother. I don't know where I've kept the others. So I'll do a different video on soothers and types of soothers. But this is just an example. So you can give them nice soothers and pacifiers so they can play also and keep taking it in mouth. Make sure to sterilize it from time to time. Then comes the toys which make thumping sound like this. Then you have drums where they can, you know, just keep paddling their legs over this and it will create nice sound. Then you have this bubbles. They love to see bubbles once they are 4 months to 5 months old, when they can feel, you know, bubbles in the air. Then soft toys is a must. Give them 2 or 3 soft toys which they can hold and sleep. Soft toys give them a sense of security and warmth when the mothers are not near them. So soft toys are a real help. I'll show you Agu's favorite, most favorite toy, soft toy. See this penguin. This is so cute. This Agu loves so much. He used to sleep with it and it also helped as a bumper. I also told you about toys which are emitting light and which are moving toys like this. So this has light and this moves also on ground. Then 1 second. Then this robot, it makes sound and it moves. So these motion toys are helpful after 4th month when the baby is able to sit and see on the floor. And these moving toys give them joy. I also had a dog, not dog, puppy, which used to flip. I don't have right now, but I'll share the link. So Agu used to be really happy seeing that. You also asked me about a mat where your child can, you know, lie down and play on the ground so that they don't get hurt. I used to buy these kind of mats. See, you can, these are, you know, detachable, and these are quite thick, good amount of foam thickness they have. And I had the bigger version of this. I don't have right now. It is in the store somewhere. So I'll put the link. You can buy that. You can join all these squares and make a nice mat and let your baby be there. You know, they are very comfortable and you're not scared that they'll fall and hurt themselves. And at 4th or 5th month, when the baby tries to sit up and you need some supporting chair which is comfortable as well, I don't have right now, but you can see in the next video I'll show you how Agu was sitting on that sofa come, you know, supporter, and it helped him a lot to erect his spine. So that is equally beneficial. Do buy that and let your baby sit on its own. So as far as my memory goes, these are the toys which I used for Agu. Some I bought online, some were gifted. So I'll be putting all these toys in the link below and you can directly click and buy them for your child. And these are, you know, I have selected the most important ones and which actually help, and they're just not a showpiece or something. I might be missing on some, but mostly I have tried to cover all the toys. Hope this video was helpful, and in my next video I'll be covering toys from 6 months to 12 months and then 12 to 18 and so on. So keep in touch, stay tuned, and keep waiting for my new video. Do subscribe and turn on the notification bell so that you don't miss on my next videos. Thanks for watching. Have a good day. Happy parenting. Thank you. Bye.